Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I'm going to show you a holster I have for my Colt Rail Gun. It's made by Garrett Industries, and the model is STX 2.0. And, you know, this isn't my first Garrett Industries holster. I've had one in the past for a Nighthawk Custom, okay, back in 2009, that accommodated a Dawson rail. They were one of the few that were able to do that for me, so that was pretty cool. Also, more recently, I have one made for a J-frame. And I could say, and I can attest to the fact that this is one of the best J-frame inside the waistband holsters out there. Granted, it's not inexpensive by any means, but it's well worth the money. I had another one of these that where the clip was over here. See, this clip is offset, and it was all black with tan leather on the inside. And actually, I sold that to some guy at the shooting range who saw that I had one. And he's like, I just have to get that. I need that thing. Hey, I'll pay you in cash. And he showed me some cash, and I was like, well, why don't you just order it? And he's like, I can't. I need it right now for my 442. So I sold it to him that night, and I went ahead and reordered another one in this fashion with black leather on the inside and a green or olive drab kydex shell on the outside with the offset clip. And this one here is really nice. You can look up my old video on that holster. Just look it up, and I really like this holster. It works out very well. So, anyways, let's get back on track here with this one. Like I said, this is a holster made for the Colt Railgun, which is not a concealed carry weapon system for me. You guys know that I carry a Glock or a revolver, one of those two. The Colt Railgun is strictly a range fun gun only, recreational range fun gun. But if the budget or funds allow, I'd like to get a holster for each pistol and revolver in my stable, because you just never know when you're going to have to grab a 1911, a Beretta M9A1, okay, HKUSP 45, and so on. So you just never know. I'd like to have that option to have one of these, you know, holster on standby for each of the weapon systems that I have in the stable. It's not possible to get one for everyone, but for the major ones that I feel that I would, you know, carry or have to use, I'll try to get holsters for those weapon systems. So the 1911 is one of those. So let's just check this holster out. So basically what you have here is a kydex shell on the outside and leather lined on the inside. I love that option right there. I think that's pretty cool. I think leather for 1911 is a good fit, because I don't want to wear out the finish, but I don't know, maybe that's just wishful thinking with full-on kydex. So having a leather line, it's more quiet on the unholster and the reholster, as well as it might save the finish a little bit. So I like that little touch right there. Hard shell on the outside, pretty cool. First thing you'll notice is what the hell's going on with this thing here. The belt loop is on the front of the holster rather than on the back of the holster. And what's up with that? Well, I guess the concept for that is basically concealment. Having the belt loop on the front makes for the back right here to have nothing's going on here, so it doesn't jut out more. So concealment, you're pulling it into your body as tight as possible, versus having another block right here or something, pushing it out, if you get what I mean. So it's on the outside. You can adjust the cant with Allen wrench here, loosening those screws up and moving this. You can adjust the cant. I like a neutral cant for 1911 at the 3 o'clock, but you can adjust the cant, you can adjust the tension. So this is an interesting concept and design. Is it concealable? I think it does its job, but I think in hot and humid summer weather, when all you got is a t-shirt, it might print a little bit still. But like I said, the concept is the belt will go through here and here, and it's going to pull this in, pulling this holster as close and tight to your body as possible without any interruption on the back here, kind of pushing it back out, jutting it back out. So, well, why don't I show you what it looks like on my person at the end of the video. But let's just check this thing out here, my Colt Railgun. We'll put it in there and see what it looks like. Basically, it just goes right in like that. And the Railgun is a freaking heavy pistol. Damn, that's heavy. That looks pretty cool, huh? So that's what it looks like. It goes in smoothly. This one doesn't need any adjustments. See that? Very quiet. You got a sweat guard back here, or a sweat shield, whatever you want to call this thing, protecting the side safety so you don't unintentionally disengage it like that, you know? So that's protecting the back there. That's pretty cool. So you got that going. So that's all I really wanted to show you, I guess. I mean, look how thin this holster is. All right, I'm gonna muzzle the camera, but look how thin that is. It's got a nice sight channel, so you're not snagging on anything. And this is, like I said, this is a railed 1911, and it fits this holster like a glove. All right, so let's check out what this looks like on my person. All right, so now we're gonna check out what this holster looks like on my person. Hopefully the lighting is okay, but I don't know, it's past midnight, but I figured I'd keep doing this video. Yes, this shirt is way too bright, but it's a Colt shirt, I had to wear it. So the STX 2.0 is on me with the Colt Railgun holstered up. As you can see, it fits really tightly to the body, okay? And that's pretty cool, because if it did have any quote unquote hardware on the back of the holster, it'll be jutting into you, jabbing you, and making you feel uncomfortable. But this holster really is slim, and it goes right up against your body. It's pretty cool. But you know, unholstering from this pretty quick and fast. So reholstering, very quiet. Okay. Looks like that if you want to check it out. I like this holster, but how concealable is it? I'm not sure, but we could check it out. But it just draws so smooth, it's pretty nice. But all right, let's check it out and see what it looks like when it's concealed underneath this t-shirt. The grip is what you have to try to conceal, so the longer the grip, the more it may print when you bend down, bend over. This is going to come out a little bit. So that's going to be up to you guys to figure out how you want to do that. But right here, it prints a little bit, but I can say this holster is riding right up against my body. So up front, right here, it's like right up there. So, and it's such a smooth draw, it's pretty cool. There's no fumbling or anything like that, it comes right out. But I have it at the 3 o'clock position, so I wonder if you adjust this belt loop right here, the front loop, move it up, you know, maybe cant it forward a little bit, move it back a little bit. Maybe that grip would tuck into the back right here, so it's kind of like concealed a little bit better. So that could be an option. But pretty much just this holster, I mean, I like it. It works out great. I'm not really sure. I would probably need more time with it if I truly wanted to carry a 1911. But it seems to work out pretty well. Guys, let me know what you think about this. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.